am I trying to say? That let us do the Bible that we read. It is good to prepare a nice message for the church, but I think we should prepare a nice message for ourselves and swallow the nice message and walk in this message, because the word of God is not an it. The word is a he. The word cannot change. The word has been before you were born. The word signed the word by its own blood. That is why the word is ever, we know. But the truth is this, that the Bible says that if you are born of God, it says, let everyone that nameth the name of the Lord depart from iniquity. Says the foundations of the Lord standeth sure, having this seal. God knows those who are his. He knows them, those who belong to him. He says, let everyone that nameth the name of the Lord depart from iniquity. If we don't know what is going on there, God knows what is going on there. If you have made her miserable, God knows. If you have killed the destiny that is inside of her, God knows. If you have killed her purpose in life, if you have caused her to bow down for nothing, God knows. If you have tied her hands against destiny, God knows. If you have bound her up, say shut up there, God knows. If you have stopped her from being useful to God, God knows. Because we want everybody to hear your name, but let her be silent at home, God knows. If you have not allowed her to flourish, God knows. He knows everything. And one day, man of God, you shall be responsible to all these actions. Whether you were pushed to act, whether you acted on your own accord, one day there shall be a cup of responsibility. Why are we saying all this? Let the church of God be saying. Let there be sanity in the church. We are begging you to remove the insanity in your home. The insanity that your wife cannot stay outside. Say, how is Pastor? It's very fine.
Everything is fine.
Everything. Yeah. Sister, why is, hallelujah. Why is it that you're here? I've been watching you. It's like this has taken 6 months.
Praise God. The Lord is on it.
It is well. God knows. God knows. When you have decided to box her up, God sees you. And you know that she's supposed to be your helpmate. I love this scripture that you read. Said, he that loveth his wife, loveth himself. Because your wife is your body. Can you just pinch your arm? Do it, Patricia. Does it pay you? I want you to do it deep. If you do it, the word will go, it will start bleeding. So you don't do it. There are many of them that are bleeding. They are bleeding.
Bleeding and bleeding.
One day, you know that what you are teaching them is wrong. And God has put you there to lead them unto perfection, to nurture and bring them up in the ways of the Lord. But then they also have their Bibles. Everyone will receive his own cup of responsibility. Everyone will receive his own cup of responsibility. He said, he that loveth his wife, loveth himself. There are many churches. There are many churches, many congregations, because the church of God is one. Many congregations that are in the foundation, you know, from the very, very, they are dead. Mm-hmm. And the walls are cracking, but nobody will know until the final one. Why? Because of the succor, the strength that they have neglected. Say, my wife doesn't know anything. She cannot go through scriptures. You see? But we are saying this against yourself. I wouldn't know whether we remember the story of Eve last week, or maybe I was writing and we talked about Eve. That we remember that we're talking about her, that the husband left her, be sorting out the fruits before I come. Go to till the ground, help me to be sorting the fruits. It didn't sit her down to let him know the mission of the Garden of Eden. That what I've been tilling the ground, but God saw that I needed the help. God took a rib and made you for me. That what I've come to do is to be my strength in that area, to be my circle. When I come back and there's a tired area for you to be able to do something. And then he was not able to tell Eve who God was. That this God that we must not disobey him. You can't disobey him. This particular tree said we should not eat from this tree. And if we eat from this tree, we are dead. He didn't teach her. And because he did not teach her, it was the wife that brought him down. It would have been a happy story, you know, if it was just for them alone. Oh, yes, you see? Yes. But what they did brought the whole world, born and yet unborn, into damnation, yes, even today. And to relate with God today has now become a choice.
Yes.
That Jesus shed his blood. If you believe in your heart that Jesus Christ is Lord, and you confess from your mouth that Jesus is Lord, then you are saved from that sin of Garden of Eden. What are we trying to say? If you don't love your wife, you hate yourself. Wherever you have boxed her, it's against yourself. Whatever you say about her all around, it's still coming back to you. All those negative stories that you cook against her, God have mercy. We are praying and we are standing on the word that the truth of the word will flow into your heart and your mind, and you will make a change. In the name of Jesus, that you'll be tired of deceiving yourself. The vision of rapture will come unto you every time, and you will hate, and you hate to throw yourself into hell. God is not prepared to throw anybody to hell, but your choice. You see, choice is very powerful, but God has already chosen for us to see life. He had already chosen. No wonder I said we shall allow him to go. That is going there to make mansions for us. Man of God, there is a mansion that is waiting for you. There's a mansion that is already built for you. Don't destroy what you have been doing for many years. Don't destroy your peace that God had already ordained. Don't destroy your joy that God had already ordained. Said he that loveth his wife, loveth himself. In all areas. Darling, when are you coming to bed? I'm busy. I'm writing a book. Oh, is the devil? Do you want the devil to use you? Don't want me to write my book? I'm studying the Bible. I'm praying. All those things will only work if you are in agreement with your wife. If you have done what you're supposed to do as a wife, as a husband, that our emotions need to be taken care of. She's not a wood. She's God's feelings. She needs your touch. You know what we are talking about. She needs your touch. When you are supposed to touch your wife and you are saying, I'm praying, your prayer doesn't reach the ceiling. You see, I'm a woman. I have a head. And everything was in the total 100% support of my husband. You understand what I mean? Bow down your head and let us pray. If you are not born again, that's the very first thing. Say, Lord Jesus, I want to be a believer. I believe that you are Lord. Now I confess your Lordship this minute. Master, write my name in the book of life and see to it that I walk in my destiny and I make heaven in the name of Jesus. And so everyone that is watching, we decree, let there be salvation to the unsaved in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let there be healing to every sick. Everyone in the hospital, everyone anywhere, we decree, let every disease be dead in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let every home that is collapsing come together in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let there be healing to every home.
Amen.
Let there be healing to every womb.
Amen.
Let there be healing to every groin.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We break the hold of Satan over your home, over your finances, over every area of your life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We break the hold of ignorance. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We decree, let miracles flow.
Amen.
Let miracles flow.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We decree that you will seek the Lord.
Amen.
You will find the Lord.
Amen.
You will understand the Lord.
Amen.
You will walk with
Amen.
Him. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You shall not be wasted.
Amen.
You shall not be aborted.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We break this cross this day, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ,
Amen.
And we lift up the name of Jesus.
Amen.